Hello folks, and welcome to an unboxing of a difference. I've actually opened the box and I needed to make sure what was in it before I could reveal what I'm about to show you. Okay, so I've had two deliveries, and the first one I had to print off the manual myself. It was a PDF file, and from the last page, there's no front cover, no back cover. This is exactly what I got on PDF, and as you can see, it's rather a chunky manual, single side print, but I put four instruction on one page so that we could get a good idea of what we're building. So from the area here, it's a dead giveaway for those that remember this TV show in the mid to late 80s. And for those that don't know, this is the Buck Rogers Starfighter from the iconic TV show Buck Rogers in the 25th century, or the mimic program was Duck Dodgers in the 24 and a half century. I had to throw that one in there, guys, sorry. This is not a UCS build. You get no stickers, no minifigs that I'm aware of. I can't see anywhere in the booklet that you do get minifigs. So it's just the ship itself, nothing more. It is a mock set, and it contains the contents of this bag. Now the bags do have numbers on them, but they are not relevant, and no, I can't see any minifigs anywhere. So let's count these out. So you've got bag one, bag two, that's bag three, there's four, and there's bag five. That's number six, the largest of them all. There's seven, eight, and the last one is bag nine. So as you can see, it's not small by any means. As I've said, it's not UCS or anything like that. No stickers, no minifigures, but it is, of the two that I saw, this is the more detailed of the two kits. The first one came with just a bog standard four-piece grey nose point where the cannons normally are on this ship. For those that know the program, the cannons were hidden within the front of the aircraft on the wing system. So I look forward to doing this as a live stream. So let me just put this out of the way, and I will bring you on to the next build that will be on live also. So once again, there's the thickness of the manual. It would have been half this size. It's a 49 page manual, so you could have downsized it if I've got the knowledge of how to work the printer that I've got. And there's a better picture there. There we go. So this is the Buck Rogers Starfighter, and it's quite a detailed kit, so I'm looking forward to getting on with this, and I hope you're going to be able to join me for this build. And this one will be built after the current build in progress. Now, secondly, I have this kit. Now, I'm going to do this reverse. I'm going to show you the book after. So, that is the main bag of all bag one parts. There are minifigs in this kit. I can clearly see there's two. And that's one bag. And then you get a little bag of three plates also. And then we have, sorry for the rustling, bag two, which you can see is also rather large. And then we have yet another sizable bag three there. And finally, we have a mediocre bag four. So as you can see, this is quite a sizable kit, and I will declare it is a UCS, and it is from my all-time favourite movie, the Star Wars series, and it's from The Empire Strikes Back. The kit number of this is M968, and it does come with stickers, as you're about to see. So that's the opening of the book, and as you can see, the stickers are very impressive, although downside to these is they're not see-through. So what you see is how they're going to be displayed. And it is the T-47 Airspeeder, also known as the Snowspeeder. It wasn't just used solely on Hoth, it was used in other areas of the solar system. As many of you will know, and as you can see, a fairly detailed manual. And before you've got to bag two, you are already a sizable area in on the main ship itself. So I look forward to building this, and as you can see, it comes with its own base and display plate that I would have put at the beginning of the build personally, but I'm not in charge of how things are done. But as you can see, the classic scoop on the front nose there of the aircraft, along with its base and plate. And then we move on to the minifigs themselves. There's two of them. They're nondescript, although one looks like Red 5. I don't think it is Luke Skywalker. And then you move on to the wings, as you can see from that. And we're getting right into this. Now, the thing I have noticed with this is it's not telling you when your next bags are to be opened. It's just, this is how it's done, and you open the bags as and when required. I've been so looking forward to getting hold of this kit. It's taken me 3 or 4 months to save the money for this one. In fact, it was 4 months, exactly 4 months before I could get this kit. And so here we go. I've been squirreling away every chance I got to put some money to one side to get this. And as you can see, the engines and the ailerons in full working order, the brakes, air brakes, not ailerons, they're the air brakes. So yeah, it's looking awesome, even in picture form. And then there we go, we continue to build with the left side of the snow speeder, and as we go we're stickering up as well, as you can see from that. A lovely build. I'm looking forward to this one, and as you can see from here, we're almost complete. Only a couple of pages left to go, and there we go, a bit more done, more cockpit area, more air brakes, more stickers, and there's the classic grill that looks like a heat sink in a stereo or something. And right to the back, we put together the actual cockpit glass, and there we go, one completed T47. And I am so looking forward to building this. Page wise, we're looking at 90 pages, 462 instructions to complete. Parts wise, I'm sorry, I didn't write that information down, so I do apologize. And finally, a reveal, the Hawk is starting to look quite good. I've got a few issues here with seam lines underneath the aircraft, a couple of joint areas there, but on the whole I would recommend this kit, even though I haven't purchased it. This was a gift, as you all know. I've got a seam line issue on the nose area, but apart from that, this kit's looking lovely. It really is looking wonderful. So thank you to Mossy over at Mossy Models. Very much gratefully received. And further to the build on the living room area that I was doing, this is what you've seen so far. The lamp is now installed. The wiring has been fed through. I've just hooked it over the top there so it doesn't get damaged. And the grills I have to do next. They will be in place shortly. And I've started working on the cabinets and the interior items for the cabinets. The handle for the door is fitted. That was made from just a piece of wire that was in the kit, and that will just sit on the cabinet like so. When I've put the perspex on and filled the cabinet up, you'll notice the spice jars, and there we are, a spice jar, and it consists of four pieces. Now, the pieces of paper that are inside, it tells you to chop them up into teeny tiny teeny incy wincy little bits. Now, fat fingers, I can't do that, so all I've done is rolled the coloured piece of paper, slipped it in the jar, and there we go, we've got spices in a jar, which I thought for me and my fingers would be ideal. One little touch I did do with this kit is I thought with the colouring it needed breaking up a bit, so keeping with the blue, I went round the inside of the frame of this door with a dark colour, a dark blue. So I just got a hobby pen from my collection and put that together. The drawers have handles that work. I don't know if you can see that, but the handles actually move. So they're done. And I then finished the bookcase cabinet, or the little corner cabinet. I've placed the parcels and the package inside, as the instructions suggested. The grill is in place. The fruit bowl's been filled with the little vase inside. The handle is a two-piece, a piece of shrink tubing, and a bit of wire. That's all done. The legs were easy enough to fit. And all I've got to do now is make the two ornaments that sit on the top. One's a kettle and one's a plant spray or something. And what I am proud of is the piano. Now, this came out really well. I did like the piano with the music sheet on the top there. And as you can see, you can flip through the pages of the music book, and it looks really nice. Nice bit of detail on this. It was a bit of a pain to do, to be honest. As you can see, I've had to go around enforcing with wood glue in the hidden area that nobody's ever going to see. What I'm going to do is put a back on this. In the traditional style, what I'm going to do is get a piece of material and cover the back with material, because some pianos just had a piece of Hessian backing with wood slats. So I thought, why not? Let's do that. But on the whole, that's come out really nice, so I'm really impressed with that. And finally, the last two pieces is the world map for the wall, and another world map of a smaller circumference or frame, whatever. There's several of these pictures to be done. So I thought you might like to see the catch up on what I've been up to and where I am with certain projects. The Thunderbird 2 build that everybody occasionally asks about is still on the back burner, I'm afraid. I need to spend a lot of time working on the Thunderbird, and I'm just not in the right frame of mind for it at the moment. I do apologize if that's what you've been looking forward to. So with that, I'm going to say thank you very much to each and every one of you. Thank you for your continued support within the channel. And if you wouldn't mind, hit that like and subscribe. And I look forward to seeing you all again. Take care for now and have a great day. Bye-bye.